children, did you read the lesson that I taught you yesterday and day before yesterday? Very good. Now, I shall tell you about Sudha's classroom. How many children are there in Sudha's classroom? There are 30 students. 30? There are 30 students in the class. Understand, that is both boys and girls. Both boys and girls together, there are 30 students in Sudha's class. How many girls and how many boys are there? There are 18 girls. And boys, 12 boys. So altogether how many? 30. Altogether how many children are there in Sudha's class? 30 children, both boys and girls together. So boys are 12 in the class and girls are 18 in the class. So altogether there are 30 children. Then when you come to school, do you sit on the ground? Do you sit on the ground and learn? No. You have a table, you have a bench. Isn't it? You have a table where you put your book and write. And you have a bench to sit on. Nice, no? And four fans in the class. Which school will have four fans? Atkinson is giving you four fans in the class. Okay. Now leave that. Then the teacher also has a chair and a table. So, this is the chair and this is the table where the teacher can sit and do the correction, and she can put the books on the table and do the correction. Understand? And there is a big blackboard. And nowadays, not only blackboards, you have boards in green color also. And who writes on the board? Who writes on the board? Tell me. You write on the board. Your class teacher writes on the board. She will explain the lesson and she will give you notes on the board where you copy down in your notebook. Very neat. Your teacher tells you, good handwriting, better than the teacher. Your writing should be better than the teacher. Finger spacing, touch the line. She keeps on telling you. So you copy down the books in notes in your book. So the teacher uses the blackboard. Of course, this is a green one. The teacher uses the board. With what does she write with? She writes with her fingers. No. What is this called? It will... What is wrong image? The teacher takes a piece of chalk and she explains to you. Then she starts writing on the blackboard. Understand? And then your miss tells you, no? Come on, make a chart of a house. Or make the chart of a birds and put it on the, where do you put it on the paper? They pin it up on the board, pin-up board. This is called a pin-up board. Understand? So, everyone will bring different charts of birds, flowers, sky, stars, moon, classroom, and then the school. So, they will bring and show, miss, this is what I made, miss. Miss will feel very happy. She says, very good, my child, very good. And she gives a tap on the, and then she pats your back. The very good children. And then she will put it up on the board. Then when the principal comes, she feels very happy. Oh, the classroom is very well decorated. Understand? And then suppose you need to sharpen your pencils. Where do you go in your place to sharpen your pencils? No, you have to go to the dustbin. See the dustbin there? You have a dustbin in the corner of the class. You go there, you sharpen your pencils, and the pencil shavings, you know, the round ones, what is sharp, that should fall into the dustbin only, not in the class or not in your places. So the dustbin, where does the dustbin be? The dustbin will be kept in the middle of the classroom. It will be kept in one corner so that you can go to the dustbin and one by one and sharpen your pencils and come back to your class and write. The teacher tells you, you know, let the point be sharp. Let your pencil points be sharp, then you will get good handwriting. Understood? So, we throw all the dust or unwanted papers, all we have to throw it in the dustbin. That is a sign of good manners. That is a sign of good manners. So, this is the way you have to keep the classroom clean. Just don't tear the pages, roll it up and put it in your place. That is a very, very bad habit. That is a very, very bad habit. You should respect your teachers. You should share things with your friends. Understood? You should follow the rules of handwriting. You should keep the classroom neat. By what? By sharpening or throwing the waste papers into the dustbin. Now you understood, children? Did you understand the lesson, my school? So, who is saying about my school? Who is saying about my school? Subha. See how nicely she is explaining about her school. Her name is New Public. Sorry, the name of her school is New Public School. Children come in uniform. Understand? And then teacher teaches them all kinds of good manners, good habits, good behavior. And then what? Sharing, writing, listening, learning new language. That is English. That's why I tell you, always speak in English with your parents also. You can improve your English language. Understood? So, the teacher teaches you so many things to share, all that she teaches you. And your classroom. How nice your classroom should be kept, you know? No throwing the things here, there and all that. You have to sharpen only in the dustbin. All the pencil shavings, when you sharpen, all the small, small things come out, no, from the pencil. All the. So that you have to keep it in the dustbin. Any waste paper, pick it up and put it in the dustbin. And make the classroom neat, look, make the classroom look neat and tidy. Understand? Yes, sir? So then, so what should we do as children? We should keep our classroom very, very neat and tidy. Understood? So this is the lesson about my school. Children, before I give you the notes, you please read the lesson at least 2 times or 3 times. And you recollect, that is, you think in your mind, what did my teacher teach us today about my school, about my classroom, about my... So all this you have to recollect in your mind, okay? And then I will give you notes afterwards. Okay, children? Very good. Very good, y'all. Okay, children, bye.